Welcome to Grab and Go Info. CheLearner is a meta learner that uses two machine learning models to estimate the individual level heterogeneous causal treatment effect. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to implement CheLearner manually using two machine learning models in Python, how to make individual treatment effect estimation using CheLearner, how to calculate average treatment effect estimation using CheLearner. Let's get started. CheLearner follows three steps to estimate individual treatment effect. Firstly, two machine learning models need to be built, one using the treated units and the other using the untreated units. Next, the predictions will be made using the two models separately for all the units, both treated and control. Finally, the individual treatment effect will be estimated by getting the difference between the predicted outcome from the treated model and the predicted outcome from the control model. To learn how to make an individual treatment effect using a single model, please check out my previous tutorial for CheLearner. In step 1, we will install and import the Python libraries. Firstly, let's install causal for synthetic dataset creation. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. Pandas is imported for data processing. Synthetic data is imported for synthetic data creation. Seaborn is for visualization. LGBM regressor is for the machine learning model training. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the CheLearner Uplift model. Firstly, a random seed is set to make the synthetic dataset reproducible. Then, using the synthetic data method from the causal Python package, we created a dataset with 5 features, 1 treatment variable, and 1 continuous outcome variable. After that, the dataset is saved in a pandas data frame. Finally, using value counts on the treatment variable, we can see that out of 5,000 samples, 2582 units received treatment and 2418 did not receive treatment. In step 3, we will process the data for the CheLearner. Firstly, the dataset DF is split into 2 datasets based on the value of the treatment variable. The treated units are saved in a data frame called DF treated and the control units are saved in a data frame called DF control. Then the feature matrix and the outcome variable are created for the treated and control data frames separately. Features include x1, x2, x3, x4, and x5. The dependent variable is the outcome column y. The names for the features are features treated and features control, and the names for the outcomes are y treated and y control. Finally, we check the shape of the modeling data for the two models. The treated model has 2582 records and the control model has 2418 records. We also need the features for all the samples for the model predictions, and we gave it the name of features. In step 4, we will train the CheLearner models. The model selection and hyperparameter tuning are important for the performance of a CheLearner. This is because the model performance affects the model predictions, hence the accuracy of the individual treatment effect estimation. Many machine learning model algorithms can be used to build the CheLearner. The model algorithms include but are not limited to lasso regression, ridge regression, random forest, XGBoost, and a neural network model. A light GBM model is used in this example, and the process is the same for other machine learning model algorithms. The two models for the CheLearner can use different algorithms. Using the LGBM regressor method, we fit the two models using the features and the outcome variable for the treated and the control group separately. In step 5, we will make predictions using the CheLearner models. To make the treatment effect estimation, 2 separate predictions need to be made using the trained models. In the first prediction, the treated model is used for the prediction of all the samples. This gives us the predicted outcome values if all the samples received the treatment. In the second prediction, the control model is used for the prediction of all the samples. This gives us the predicted outcome values if none of the samples received the treatment. In step 6, we will calculate the individual treatment effect using the CheLearner predictions. Individual treatment effect is the difference between the predicted outcomes with and without treatment. After calculating the individual treatment effect, the data is saved in a data frame. The histogram visualization of the individual treatment effect shows a normal distribution. The average treatment effect is around 0.5. Most individuals in the dataset have a positive treatment effect. Some individuals have negative treatment effects. In step 7, we will estimate the average treatment effect using the CheLearner predictions. The average treatment effect for the population is the average of the individual treatment effect. We can see that the average treatment effect is 0.58. To learn more about the definition and calculation for the average treatment effect, please check out my previous tutorial 8 vs. Kate vs. ATT vs. ATC for causal inference. The customer segmentation using individual treatment effect from the CheLearner is the same as the CheLearner. For the details about how to segment customers, please check out my previous tutorial S-Learner Uplift Model for Individual Treatment Effect and Customer Segmentation in Python. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about the Uplift models, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.